already know just where I be, dog. I ain't being cocky, but Philly what I'm reppin'. Watch me check it like it's hockey. I ain't tryna get it twisted. If you get it, then you got me. If you with it, cool. If not, I'll treat you like a Tamagotchi. I'ma let you down point. Yeah, I never disappoint.
What's going on, guys? Jay Hoyt back with you today here on some Fortnite solo gameplay. We got 5 kills with 6 people left, so we technically have a good game going. And you know, I was really enjoying this gameplay because it's my first game, I think, of the day, if I'm not mistaken. But we were playing good up to this point, and you know, we kept it going with the win here in this episode. But today I wanted to talk about kind of just the gameplay. You know, didn't really have anything else to really talk about. Just kind of how my brain's evolving while playing Fortnite. And, you know, in this fight right here, you know, I don't know how I could have played this any better. Because I heard this guy. Don't get me wrong. I heard this guy. But, honestly, I thought it, he was a bot, essentially. Like, he didn't really know what he was doing. Because if you look at where I am, I'm technically outside of the next zone. And I'm not really in rotation for the next zone. So, how he got up here, I don't know. And why he would come up here, I don't know. Unless he really wanted my kill, which I don't really see why you would, especially in the position that he was. But I could have played that smarter. I just don't know how, in the sense. Because, you know, with 6 people left and about 40 seconds left until the zone moves, you still have to rotate down a mountain. And I'm up here full 100-100 with, you know, a good kit, don't get me wrong, but, like, I just don't know why he would have played it like that. But he ended up being, like, you know, semi-competent where he was able to respawn. But as you can tell, I'm kind of low on health, and I thought I remembered seeing a campfire in this vending machine. And, you know, I got one of those, I had the extra metal. You know, was it worth it? You know, possibly. You know, should I have dropped maybe my submachine gun for those bandages? Probably, but hey, you know what, we make it out of the zone and make it out of the storm, essentially, to get perfect timing on this guy running up here to our north. And you know what we do? We just follow him because, you know, if we get in a fight, most likely the third guy's going to be there as well. And I just kind of tunnel visioned hard on this guy. Like, I know there's 3 people left in this gameplay. I remember this one. I was like, I know there's 3 people left, but I don't know where the third guy is. So, you know, we see this guy, you know, peek behind a tree, and, you know, we end up seeing the guy off to our right here, and we don't actually see that because I'm tunnel visioning super hard. This guy hits a great hunting rifle shot on us, and he predicted it perfectly where we were about to land. And I'll give you a little behind the scenes thing. Now, I peek into this little shed, and I completely ignoring, you know, the left side of my screen where all that building is. I was playing for the kill inside this little shed. And I saw a little thing in the corner that I thought was a person's gun sticking out, and it turned out to be the chair. So a little bit of behind the scenes intel, I guess. But in this situation, I was playing for kind of the third party in a sense. So the other 2 guys would fight, because I know both of them are there. And I was kind of hoping they would fight, and I would come in at the third party level and you know, kill them. But I hear this guy, you know, bounce padding away, trying to get to the next zone. And, you know, it kind of sucks because this was a really bad zone for us because we came down to this, like, really non-advantageous spot. And it was a really, really bad position. So we upgrade our sniper, we upgrade our assault rifle, and we just completely ignore the other tactical shotgun on the ground. And we just don't even think twice about it. But here we are, 15 seconds left until the zone moves. I'm playing the very, very late rotation here because I know the one guy's pretty much already probably to the next zone, right? Like, he's already gone. The second guy, I'm assuming, is still in the base to my left, or, you know, rotating up to my left somewhere. But then we hear this guy jump down essentially to our right. And I was like, all right, you know, we'll just spread this guy out. He'll probably be weak. And I don't know how, but Bloom just hates me, and I miss every single bullet. However, we see this guy, you know, catch him late rotating, hit him with 5 shotgun shots, and then he hits the bounce pad and tries to build, and, you know, he just was super weakened, couldn't really do anything. So we try to build one more time to play kind of the gatekeeper on the zone, and he, for whatever reason, I don't know what kind of play that was, but he just kind of lost himself the game, in a sense, like, without even a chance of coming back. But, you know, we end up securing the win and taking home the pride and glory of the Victory Royale. But if you guys did enjoy, hit the like button down below. If you have not already, hit the subscribe button. And as always, guys, we'll see you next time. Stars on my body so I can take you wherever, like I want you forever.